Hey dear students, we are discussing about the density of holes, density of electrons in a semiconducting material, that is intrinsic semiconductors. These semiconductors classified into two categories. The first one is elemental semiconductor, elemental, and the next one is compound semiconductors. So, in the case of elemental semiconductors, it is further classified into two categories. One is intrinsic semiconductor, the next one is extrinsic semiconductors. So, what do you mean by intrinsic semiconductor and what do you mean by extrinsic semiconductors? If you draw a line between the intrinsic and extrinsic. The intrinsic means pure semiconductors. Nothing but the number of electrons is same as the number of holes. The extrinsic semiconductor means we have to dope certain elements, in a semiconducting material, so it becomes impure, it becomes an impure semiconductor. So this is the pure semiconductor. So today's class we are going to talk about the intrinsic semiconductors. My target is first I have to calculate the density of charge carriers, the density of charge carriers in conduction band, similarly the density of charge carriers in valency band. The first I am taking the density of charge carriers like electrons and the number of holes in a valency band. First, I am talking about the density of charge carriers in a conduction band. To calculate this, the first I am writing the energy level diagram E. So, this is said to be the valency band and this is said to be the conduction band. In an intrinsic semiconductor, the Fermi level at the center. This Fermi level tells about the probability of finding the number of charge carriers, which are majority like electrons or holes. In the case of valence intrinsic semiconductor, the number of holes, this is the number of holes, and the number of electrons will be the same. So the number of electrons is same as the number of holes. So my interest is to calculate the density of charge carriers in a conduction band. To evaluate this, I'm considering this is the conduction band. This maximum, it goes up to the infinity. Here I am assuming there are number of energy levels in a conduction band. The minimum is EC, the maximum is infinity. This is the n number of energy levels in a conduction band. Here I am assuming certain energy levels here. The separation between this is E and E plus DE. So within the DE energy gap, how many number of density of states are available? Density of states are available. I have to calculate. Then, so once the electron leaves from here, so it will occupy, it creates the number of holes. So first my target is that how many number of density of states are available. Then the second one is in what way these electrons can be arranged. So here I have to go for a Fermi Dirac probability function. This is the Fermi Dirac probability function. Here let the dn, let dn be the number of electrons available in the energy level, but in the energy level E and E plus dE. This can be written as dN is equal to Z of E and F of E dE. This Z of E indicates the density of states, available in the energy difference E and E plus dE. F of E is the probability function. So to calculate the number of electrons available in the energy difference E and E plus dE in the conduction band, I am trying to use this particular relation. So what is the value of Z of E? This Z of E, the density of states available in the conduction band, can be written as 4 pi by h cube 2 me star. Me star is nothing but effective mass whole to power of 3 by 2. Next one is E minus EC whole to power of half. I'll write Z of E dE with the difference of energy. So this is the dE, where EC is the minimum of the conduction band. This is the conduction band energy level. E is the energy, Me star is the effective mass. The effective mass is nothing but when an electron moves in a perfect periodic potential well, the mass is going to be changed. That mass is said to be the effective mass. So this is the density of states available. Then the F of E, the probability function, the electron occupying probability function, that can be written as 1 by 1 plus exponential E minus EF by KBT. EF is a Fermi level, KB is a Boltzmann constant, T is the temperature. So these are the two equations. Equation number 2, this is equation number 3. If 2 and 3 as substitute in the formula, so the d of n can be written as 4 pi by h cube 2 me star 3 by 2 e minus ec whole to power of half into f of e 1 plus exponential E minus EF by KBT. Here my target is to calculate the number of charge carriers available in the conduction band here. The minimum is energy is EC. The maximum is up to infinity. So if you write the number of density of electrons, I'll write the electrons. The density of electrons, the starting energy level is EC with respect to this, the maximum is infinity. So if you write this one, 4 pi by h cube 2 n e star whole to power of 3 by 2 e minus ec whole to power of half into 1 plus exponential e minus e f by k b t. So this is a mathematical expression. After simplification using some mathematical functions, after simplifying, this, the density of electrons in the conduction band, that can be written as 2 times of 2 pi me star kbt by h square whole to power of 3 by 2, the exponential minus of ec minus ef by kbt. So this is the density of electrons available in the conduction band, can be written as n is equal to 2 pi m star effective mass kbt whole power of 3 by 2 by h square exponential of minus ec minus ef by kbt. Similarly, we can calculate the density of holes available in the valency band. So how we can calculate? The same expression here for the next one, to calculate the density of holes, the same thing expression. So let, I'm assuming dp be the number of holes available in the energy level in the valency band. Suppose if you consider this, this can be written as the formula, the same energy level diagram. This is the valency band, this is the conduction band, this is the intrinsic Fermi level. We calculated here the number of electrons available in the conduction band. I'm talking about here the valency band here. Let us assume the same process. There are a number of energy levels. So with respect to this, with an energy level E plus DE and E, the difference is DE. Let DP be the number of holes available. So this can be written as the same way. DP is equal to Z of E, the density of states available in the valency band, and it is multiplied with the probability of number of holes. I'm writing, initially I have written here electrons, here I'm writing this E, this one. So Z of E, D, the density of states available, F of H into E. This is the F of H, E is nothing but the probability of distribution of holes in the difference of energy level DE. This is the hole. As per the probability statistics, the hole concentration can be calculated. F of H, E holes plus electron is equal to 1. So using this probability, the probability of finding the holes plus electron is equal to 1. From this I'll write F of H E is equal to 1 minus F of E into E. So I'll use this one in this one. So already you know this electron, so I'll write that is equal to 1 minus 1 plus exponential E minus E F by K B T. After simplification, after simplification,